Hello and welcome to my channel Skanda Prasad. I know it's been almost a week since I've uploaded any video. So here it goes. The actual thing is I burnt my table lamp. So teaching is a little bit difficult without that lamp actually. And I have to buy a new one. And till then, I thought of making the guidance videos, let's say a couple of videos, which many people were requesting me about how to prepare for CET in last 1 month, etc., etc. So I'll take up one by one slowly, and I'll do it everything. I'll do everything. So don't worry about it. In this video, I want to talk about preparation of 1 month strategy, and in parallel to that, I'll be talking about what are the books you're supposed to refer in these final days, whether you should buy something new or not. So all those things we'll discuss in this video. I'll be talking about three categories, that is below average, above average, and let's say you're the topper of really good student. So all three categories of students I'll be covering, so that nobody of you is left out, and all of you have a proper preparation strategy you should have by the end of this video, and I'm very sure about it that you will have, right? So first, let's talk about what are the books you should have to prepare in this last 1 month, right? It's 28th, approximately 1 month is left, that's it, right? 30 days. What I wanted to tell is, first, let's say you're a category of student who's got the resource materials such as Dinesh or MTG or let's say Bosco or whatever it is. You have some extra publication, some other publication books you have. And what extra do you need to score good marks? Well, you have to have, no matter what category of students you fall into, you need to have exemplar book and a book of previous year papers. I've been telling that in comments also, but I don't know how many of you read the comments, but these two extra books are must required, whether you belong to toppers category or below average or above average, whatever it is, you need to have these two books for sure, because from previous year paper, I'm not telling from last year questions are copied, I'm not telling that way. What I'm telling is from previous year, let's say 3 to 4 years previous papers, from those one or two, three questions, they will be copied for sure. All the other questions are completely similar. Please write that down. All of the questions should seem similar to you, if not same. That is the reason I keep telling it to solve everybody the previous year papers. I hope you get it. And exemplar book is a must. That's also a must do book. Must read book, because many good questions are there, little of higher level, so that you're well versed in those type of questions, so that these questions seem easy to you. In that psychological concept is what I keep telling you, that confidence is the key in the final days. So to maintain that, you have to do these two things, that is solve previous year papers, so that you feel, you get an exam kind of feel, and the other one is solve a little more difficult problem, so that these seem easy for you. Both these things are important. You have to do both type of levels, the normal CET level, which you'll be doing in, from your previous year papers, and a little bit higher level from your exemplar book. I hope you understand this much. So this is what everybody of you have to do. Now, let's say you don't have these Bosco or MTG or whatever, Dinesh, you don't have all those. What are you supposed to do? Don't buy them. It's not required, because you're left with 1 month. After that, what will you do with those books? No need. Buy exemplar, buy the previous year papers, follow what I told. Not just buy, you have to solve it how much ever possible. I'll tell you how to solve also, don't worry about that. And the next thing is, those of you who don't have literally any books, for those, obviously, again, buy these two books, previous year and exemplar. If you don't have exemplar, I think you'll already have. So whatever it is, these two books are must, and others, other type of books, if you have, well and good, do them also. If you don't have, buy these two, this much is enough, so that you're well versed. So this is what I wanted to talk about, the books, regarding the books. Now let's talk about preparation strategy, right? Let me talk about first the toppers category, right? Now all of you are... I feel that by this time, as I told, 1 month is left. All of you will be pretty sure, pretty thorough with the concepts, and pretty sure that what type of questions are going to come. You have a good idea. So you should be having by this time, right? You guys should be aiming around, let's say 100 to 200 ranks. In that range, you should aim, because that's difficult thing to get. Agree. It's difficult for everybody, be it toppers or be it anybody else. It's difficult, I agree, but since you have the capability, you need to make sure you enhance your performance in the last 1 month, so that you get it. How do we do it? I'll talk about that. So that is all the concepts, you already know it by this time. All you have to do is, again, as I said, just practice the like papers. Others and all can practice like without time limit, but you guys need to keep a timer of let's say keep whatever is the time limit, keep 5 to 10 minutes, less than the original time limit, because that helps in speed and accuracy. Let's say you start getting something around 50 to 52 marks out of 60 in each subject when you take practice tests in your home, right? Any test is okay, like from either internet or from previous year paper. Also you can take it as a test by keeping OMR sheets with you. That also can be done. So either of those things, you have to do it, right? And that's what as I said, keep 10 minutes less time limit and see how much you are able to score. And in the other 10 minutes, during the exam, you'll understand that time that it was a good idea that I practiced that way. And now you get time to even revise. At least you get time to glance all the questions and see if any mistake. I could do it. I found 2-3 mistakes in each paper of the CET. First day it was maths, and next it was chemistry and physics. I could find questions because 5 minutes I was somehow getting extra. I had attempted all the questions, how much ever I could, and a few questions which I couldn't get at all, those I could make an analyzed guess also. For that I had 5 to 7 minutes extra. That is what I had, in that way I had practiced, and that is a really good way. Right, so please practice this. This was about the toppers category of students. Right, you're all very good. All the best, and you will you'll do really well. I'm very sure of it. And now let's talk about the above average kind of students. Your mindset will be something like this. You feel that you have done a kind of good preparation, but you don't have that exam. How to tackle the situation in the exam. That's what you don't know. That is the exposure kind of. The psychological thing that is not there in you guys. You have preparation, but the confidence is a little problem. That is what I'm talking about. I was kind of in between the toppers category and above average. I was mostly shifted towards the above average, but a little bit I had good concept, good hold of concepts. So that was one good thing, but otherwise, and this was the case, I was an above average student, so that I didn't have that much confidence, but later on I practiced many papers, and then finally I built confidence, and finally I got desirable results. So that's what I wanted to say. So you guys need to keep up with confidence. Don't buy any more books. All of your parents will be surely asking, and my parents used to ask, do you need any other resources? Please let me know. I'll get you those. All of the parents will be very supportive this time, but say no to all those books. You don't need them anymore. As I told, buy those 2 books, enough. More than buying, it's important that you do it, you solve it, you understand, you learn. That is more important, right? I hope you understand this point. So this was about above average category of students. You don't have to do much. Preparation is there, I agree. But keep up with your confidence. Take breaks more often. Listen to songs. Let's say you have siblings or something, you start dancing with them in the evenings. Just for a relaxation, you need all those things, right? That is more important. Don't just sit in front of computer and watch a movie. That takes away time. Don't sit on social media. That also takes away time. Do something like this. Spend time with the family, which is more important, right? Because that is what you have been avoiding in these last 2 years for preparation. Do those in this final moment. It will keep your keep your mind relaxed. This also is applicable to the all other categories also. Let's say toppers or below average or above average. It is very important. And I did that, right? It helps keep the mind in a relaxed state. So this was about the above average. Let's talk about below average students. I don't like calling it that way, but what to do? We have to categorize in some way so that you get proper guidance, right? You don't have good preparation nor confidence. So what do you do? That is very, very important. First, preparation, since you have not done much in these last 2 years, don't you feel that you can't enhance suddenly your performance? Let's talk reality, right? Let's be realistic. You can't suddenly increase your performance and start getting under 500, under 1000 rank without any preparation. That's highly unrealistic, and I wouldn't say impossible. It's possible if you're really willing to work hard. That's very important, right? If you're able to do that, then well and good. But the thing is, you have to start building up confidence. Take papers. It's okay if you get 20, 30 out of 60. No problem. Keep full time limit. But the more important thing is analysis of paper. That is more important for you people. What mistakes did you do? What you couldn't do in the paper? Why didn't you do it? Those things you have to analyze. And after taking the paper, you have to recheck it once more and learn what you couldn't do it. That is very important. After the paper, papers everybody will practice. There's no issue in that. But who analyzes the paper and who corrects their mistakes, they are going to improve, right? Please understand this very well. Even your teachers must have told you all this, right? It's getting dark actually, so I'll be continuing the video, this, in my house itself. So I'm back at my house to continue the recording. The thing is, I was talking about the below average students and their level of preparation and how to prepare. As I said, it's harsh to be realistic to say that since your preparation level is not too good, how can you enhance it? Confidence is the key to like boost your score, and preparation is required. Obviously, just with confidence, you can't do anything. That is true. So how to prepare and how to build the confidence, that is what I'm going to tell you, right? Please understand this very, very carefully. Now, you will start feeling that since preparation is not good, from where shall I read, what to do and how to practice, right? You don't know the theory very well. What do you do? 1 month is left. If you see that, it's kind of a lot of time. Once you'll feel, okay, it's very near, but just have a look at it. 24 hours in one day and 30 more days. So 24 into 30 is like 720 hours. That's too much, right? You can really make a difference in that much amount of time. What can you do is pick up NCERT of all three books, right? On each day, make it a point. Let's say I can talk about two things here, whether you're going to a crash course or not going to a crash course, right? Since you're the student who are going to the crash course and you are below average student. So what you have to do is, almost from morning to, let's say, afternoon 3 to 4, till that time, average time, let's say, your time is gone in college itself, wherever you go. After that, you have to do these things. First thing is, pick all the three NCERT textbooks. Make it a point that you read a complete chapter of each subject. If you're taking biology, you will have to do it. No other choice. Since your preparation is not good, you have to be willing to work hard. That is, read NCERT, sit properly, and read it completely. Keep a rough book or anything. Start jotting down points wherever you see. It'll be a tedious process, I agree, but you have to sit. There's no other choice, right? So finish this, and by night, come back from college and take rest. I'm not telling no for that. Take an hour rest, sleep for some time or take a nap or whatever. Have food and all those things. You do all that, there's no issue in that. But this is what you're supposed to do after doing all that. After relaxation, NCERT is a must. You have to read the theory. I'm sure day by day, if you keep on doing this continuously, if you make it a routine, let's say for at least 10-15 days, then you'll start getting confidence. You'll start feeling better. At least one chapter, pick up 12 standard, pick 12 standard textbooks more, as much as possible. And 11th, I'm not telling ignore it. 11th also, you can read half of chapter if you want, but more weightage will be from 12th itself. Let's say 65-35 is the ratio, I can say that much, right? Almost 70-30, almost it's like that. So pick 12 chapters more first, so that what you know, what you have learned in recent times, that you get covered easily. So after reading NCERT, let's say you take around 3.5 hours to do this. At night, pick up a question paper. Let's say take 1 hour test. There's no issue. But if you have time, you can stay up a little late. Let's say till at least 12:30, 1 in the night. 1 a.m. Then it's really good. So pick. Let's say you can do two papers somehow. You can manage to take two question papers. Pick chemistry and pick mathematics. Let's say for one day, right? Keep time limit as 1 hour or 70 minutes or how much ever it is. Take the test. And then finally, just before sleeping, analyze what and all you have made a mistake. And just mark those questions which you have to learn tomorrow. Next day morning, you get up early, how much ever possible. Let's say at least 6 o'clock. Let's say you have college from 8 o'clock. So 6 to 7, you prepare. Those questions you try to solve again. Or just look up the theory behind it. Usually, CET questions will be on formula itself. There's no doubt on that. Not everything is conceptual, right? So learn those formulas, write it down somewhere. That's what you have to do. Analysis of paper is really, really important. As I told, this is how you're supposed to analyze, right? You have to use the time very effectively if you're going to crash course. This is what I... for you guys, right? Now let's say you don't go to crash course, you're in the completely you have holidays now for complete 1 month. What do you do? And you're, let's say you're not writing any other exams like JEE Main or anything else, you're focusing completely on CET. What are you supposed to do? You guys can, since your concept is not too well, pick two chapters of NCERT of each subject. You have a whole day, come on, get up in the morning and till night you have, that's a lot of time in one day, right? Everybody gets the same amount of time, but how much did you utilize? Were you better than yesterday? That is what makes more important. Compete with yourself, not with others. Don't just waste time asking others like, how much did you study or how many hours. Beginning I had that habit, but then later I understood it's me who have to compete with and not others. That is, thinking about everybody else is a complete waste of time. Think about yourself first, because you are in this position where you feel that you won't get a good rank and good marks. So first focus on yourself to improve yourself, right? If you want to help others, you can, but keep it in limit, right? That's what I wanted to say. So what you guys do is pick two chapters of NCERT, and finally before sleeping at night, take let's say all three subjects. PCM, you take a test like 1 hour. Final from at least from 8 o'clock in the night, 8 to 9 you take one test, 10 to 11 and 11:30 to 12:30. And then finally revise how much ever you can, analyze your paper, and finally sleep and get up at how much ever time you have. You have a complete day, right? But utilize completely. This is what I wanted to say. NCERT, increase the chapters, number of chapters. You can pick one from 12th, one from 11th. You can do that for a fee subject and read it completely, jot down points, how much ever possible. It's possible, like one day is too much, as I told. It's possible if you do it, if you effectively utilize your time. So this is a strategy which I could think of and which will be really helpful. NCERT is really good. If you don't feel like reading NCERT and you start getting the, you get a feeling that NCERT is like very bulky, lot of pages are there. Then if you start feeling that at least you have little hold of concept, something you can do it even if you don't read NCERT, then pick up the question banks, whatever you have, MTG or whatever, if you have it. And if there are many problems, let's say around 100-200 problems, take alternative questions. Do 1-3-5-7-9 till how much ever possible, or 2-4-6-8-10 till how much ever is there. Do alternative questions. If there are like 400-500 questions per chapter, go for like alternative 3-3 or something like that. But at least you should get a satisfaction feeling. That is that is more important. That satisfactory feeling of you have completed some chapter, something you have done, something you are good at. That kind of feeling, that kind of confidence is more important, and you have to do it, right? So this is what I wanted to say for all the three, all categories about the preparation. I told first about the books, and now I've told about the preparation strategy for each and every type of students. I hope this was helpful, and let me know in the comment section how you felt it. And finally, I'd like to end by saying all the best to all of you for preparation, and prepare really well. And if you have any other queries relating preparation, do use the comment box. I'll surely reply to that. And with that note, finally, thank you for watching this video. Thanks a lot.